Good morning to all the students. So today in the first period only, though it is an arrangement, but we will be utilizing it. Fine. We'll be doing the topic of determiners. Very important topic, and you can expect 3 to 4 questions based on determiners only. Why? Because in editing also, when there is some wrong input is given and you are supposed to correct it, 1 or 2 are based on determiners. Fine. And itself also in gap filling also they give determiners, so its importance rises in this case. So kindly, I have just drawn that box and all the categories, all the types of determiners. Clear? So you need to draw this box firstly. Now I'll be picking up 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and I'll be explaining to you. Fine. First of all, we need to understand what are determiners. Its name is speaking volumes. Means its determiner name is telling us that what do you mean by a determiner. Determiner means which determines the noun that follow. Fine. Means immediately after that, we have used a determiner, and immediately after that, a noun comes. Fine. So determiner's work is to tell us about the noun. It will be determining the quantity, quality, or whatsoever. Fine. By reading the different types, we will understand it. So what is a determiner? Determiner fix, define, or determine the noun that follow them immediately after the noun. Clear? Whenever you see a determiner in a sentence, you should be very much sure that okay, the next word will be a noun only. You cannot expect any other thing or any other part of speech after determiner. Clear? Whenever we will be using any determiner, immediately after that, next word will be a noun. Clear? You should remember this. So noun is going to work in the sentence, that we should understand. Let's start with the first category of determiner that is very easy, that you have done in class 1 and 2 even. Articles. Fine. So examples of articles: a, an, the. Fine. Leave a space, 2-3 lines in between, because you need to write the usage also. Clear? Or if you want to just listen, you can listen. If you want to note down, that will be beneficial for you. A and the. These three words are considered articles in English. So this is the first category of determiner. Clear? Now, a and an both occur before countable singular nouns. ये तो सबको पता चल गया कि इसके बाद noun होएगा. Now what sort of noun will be there? That I am going to tell you. Clear? Singular noun. I say an apple means one apple. I say a desk, a book. It means one book. So what the purpose of this article is? It is determining the quantity of the noun which is following it. Clear हुआ? कोई doubt तो नहीं किसी को? Let me make you understand again. ये सबको clear है that after the article, which parts of speech will come? Noun. So if I say a book, book is a noun here. So I am telling you that one book is there. If I say an umbrella, it means one umbrella. So what is the purpose of a and an? They are determining the noun, that it is one in number. Clear? Similarly, the article is a specific article which tells us about the particular nouns. If I say the Taj Mahal, how many Taj Mahals are there? The sun, the moon, one and only. Clear? So this article is determining the quantity. Clear? A and the. Now the difference of a and an, can anyone tell me where to use a and where to use an? Very easy it is. Yes, what's your name? Yes, Laksh, please stand up. You're right. An is used with vowel sounds and a is used with consonant sounds. Fine. This is what we lack. So there are 26 letters in English. Fine. Five vowels are there. A, E, I, O, U. Rest 21 are consonants. So when consonant sound will be there, we use a. When vowel sound is there, we use an. Clear? Now, next one is demonstratives. You know, English languages, people think it's very difficult, but it is not. Because the very name of that word will tell you. Demonstrate means to show. Demonstratives means to show something to someone. If I say this girl, she is sitting near to me. Her Simran is sitting near to me. I'm saying this girl. Clear? If I say that boy, I just point towards Laksh and I say that boy because he's at distance. I'm showing a person or an object to you. I'm demonstrating to you. Clear? If I say this girl, now remember the things and persons who are near to us. For them, I will be using this and these. If it is single, this. Suppose I say these girls, Princy and her Simran. These girls. If it is more than one, I will be using these. If it is singular, I'll be using this. Clear? Similarly, for that and those, I will be using, if suppose that light is not working right now, if I say, I point towards an object which is far away from me and it is single, that light. Suppose both the lights stopped working. I say, those lights are not working these days. Fine? So demonstrative determiners, clear to all of you? This, that, these, those, though only four in number. Very easy to remember. This, that, these, those. Children sitting at home, is it clear? Send me thumbs up. I'm really sorry if I'm not interacting much with the ones who are at home because we have many students in the class. So that's why our preference goes here. Okay, but you should understand. If any doubt, you can ask me. Clear? This, that, these, those. Everyone, any doubt? So let's move. Next one is possessive. You might have heard this sentence. He's very possessive about this thing. And we use very casually. She's very possessive about her phone. He's very possessive about his privacy. He never lets us in. Fine? So being possessive is possessions. You might have heard people keep on accumulating possessions. Means if you are possessing something, you are owner of that thing. I possess this bag. I possess this tablet. I possess this book. You possess this kit. Clear? That mask is yours, obviously. So these are your possessions. Clear? What do you mean by possessions? Fine? Any doubt? Now, possessive determiners, I'll tell you. Because when we know the meaning, it is very easy. If I say my book, so which word is telling that book is mine? My. So that becomes possessive determiner. Very easy. If I say his notebook, fine. In that way, his become another possessive determiner. And in the same way, if I say, clear, that this bag is yours, that watch is mine. Mine word here telling me that this belongs to me. The words which will be telling about the possessions, chahe wo possession meri hai ya aapki hai, kisi aur ki hai. Clear? So it becomes possessive determiners. Jaldi se beta, those who have entered, rather than talking, kindly open the notebook. and take notes. Very easy. Possessive. Now let's do the example of possessive now. My keep writing. I'll be checking your notebooks. Those who are sitting at home, even I'll be seeing on the screens. Our, your, his, her, their, more than one person's, fine. You have a doubt? Or this question is related to the topic? If it is not, then I won't answer. If your query is related to the topic I'm teaching, then you're most welcome. Okay? So my, our, your, his, her, their, it's also. Clear? ITS. They all fall into the category of possessive determiners. Now, we will be doing exercises also related to this. Clear? Firstly, understand all the categories of determiners. Now we have ordinals with us. If I say first boy in the class, last girl sitting at the bench, fine. That last boy, I point out in that way, na? First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Clear? Very easy. Ordinals. They are ordinals. Clear? So you can write first, second. I need not write all. Third, etc. Third, last. Fine, in that way. These are the ordinals. Ordinal numbers you might have done in the maths also. Fine, then cardinals. You know cardinals, Princy? Demonstratives. Ordinates are there, okay. In cardinal numbers, it will be like one boy. If I say one boy has completed the work, rest of the boys have not completed. So one is... Clear? Three of girls, three girls of your class got same marks, if I say. Clear? So these numbers are cardinals. One, two, three, in that way. Five, etc. And we also call these cardinals, we also know these cardinals as numerals. Cardinals or numerals, one and same thing. I will be seeing the notebooks, those who have noted down or not. Clear? Cardinals or numerals, 1, 2, 3, 5, etc. Ordinals, first, second, third, last, etc. Immediately, better take note of this box, it should be there. Apart from this also, we have more determiners, but these are the basic determiners. Clear? There are more than that, but mainly we use these determiners only. Clear? Articles, quite often used. Priority wise, I have written. Then demonstrative usage is there. And then possessive is used, and then priority wise, I have written. Clear? I would be sharing the screen with the student sitting at home. And here also you will note down beta if I'll be. Screen is visible to all of you. You can see this box. Here I have missed two, three things in the box which were not required, but you can take screenshot if you want. Clear? So determiner is a word used before a noun to indicate which things or people we are talking about. Clear? I'm speaking for you all. Determiner is a word used before a noun to indicate which things or people we are talking about. Determiner is a word used before a noun to indicate which things or people we are talking about. The words a, the, my, this, some, etc. are called determiners that we have already done. Now, give the heading beta of one exercise. The ones at home, beta, you can take screenshot of this box. Clear? I'll be speaking one passage. Fine, and you are supposed to fill determiners into it. Write down, fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks by using appropriate determiners. Fill in the blanks by using appropriate determiners. First passage is number one. Dalo. This is to be done in your fear notebook because you will be giving me the answers. Number one. There was a dash. There was small a, fine. A dash. Accident near B dash. A, B, C, D ko in brackets mein rakhna hai, fine. B dash market this morning near B dash market this morning full stop market this morning full stop a car hit a bicycle. Beta, this is just one paragraph only, okay? Only 3-4 lines will be there. You have to fill in the blanks. A car hit a bicycle and C dash. A car hit a bicycle and C dash. Man on D dash. Bicycle was killed. This is first. Let's do the second also. It is very easy to acquire. Second passage, beta. It is very easy to acquire a bad habit. It is very easy to acquire a bad habit, comma, A dash. It is very easy to acquire a bad habit, comma, A dash, as eating too many sweets. Or to B dash food. or drinking too much fluid or drinking too much fluid of C dash or drinking too much fluid of C dash kind C dash kind comma or smoking C dash kind KIND or smoking full stop. The more we do D dash thing, the more we do D dash thing, comma, the more we tend to like it. The more we tend to like it. You solve it. I'll be writing something else on the board for you. Without talking. Yes, beta. Voice. Solve it within 2 minutes. Last second. I would be calling you here. Children sitting at home also, beta. Kindly note down another category that you can write it last also, if not in the box. Yes. No, any, some, all, both, either, neither. Last second, boy, again, I'm just naming. If anything is left, leave it. Rather than disturbing, please. Etc. Means abhi bhi khatam nahi hua hai. It's quite a lengthy topic. This is the last category of determiner. Fine. This is to be noted down by you all. Indefinite pronouns. Main abhi samjhaungi aapko. A car hit a bicycle and C dash man on D dash. Second is, it is very easy to acquire a bad habit, comma, A dash, as eating too many sweets or too B dash food or drinking too much fluid of C dash kind. Or smoking, the more we do D dash thing, comma, the more we tend to like it. Yes, tabhi likhe. I have beta these to be used in the passage which I have given you. Fine. I'll make you understand now. What are indefinite pronouns? Let's understand, then you can solve the exercise because we are going to use it. Clear? Now the name in itself tell pronouns, you all know the words which are used in place of nouns. rather than writing. When you write an article, suppose you're talking about your mother, my mother is a very good woman, she keeps on working. You won't be writing my mother, my mother, my mother. You start using she in place of my mother. So the words which are used in place of noun, which replace nouns, they are called pronouns. Clear? Indefinite pronouns. When it is not definite, when number is not definite, in the case of rest of things, it was determined that my book, it was determined that this belongs to me. One umbrella. This was determined that umbrella is one. But in this case, this is indefinite. Clear? If I say little sugar is left, some children are sitting, identity is not clear to us. Fine. Every child of this class, each and every student, we use commonly this word. Fine. Neither this nor that, either this or that, in that way. These are considered indefinite pronouns. Fine. Let me tell you the brief usage of all. Both is used when we're talking about two things or persons. All is used when we talk about all or as a whole. Either is used when we are talking about two options. Means either this or that. Neither is also used when none of the things can be applied. Neither you can go out nor you can sit idle. You have to study. Clear? I'm giving condition to you. Neither nor. Many, which can be counted on fingers. Many children are there, but I can count them. Then we use many. Much sugar is left. Uncountable noun. Sugar cannot be counted. Salt cannot be counted. Then we will be using much. Similarly, in case of few and little. With countable, we use few. With uncountable, we use little. Little water is left. Little juice is left. You cannot count juice and water. Fine. A few balls are left in my pit. Clear? I am having a few bats, old bats. Let's play. Fine. In which countable is there, then we use a few. Means a few, not many. Yes, what's your question? I am not saying many. If you have more number, then many. If you have less, then you'll be using a few. Clear? But it should be countable object. Any doubts to anyone? Sitting at home, children, beta, please tell me. Send me thumbs up. Kindly note down. Send me thumbs up. Tanya is the first one. Yes, Hasita. Harleen. Fine. I'll be telling you. I'll be ending this. We have still 5 minutes with us. And we will be doing, where do we use little, a little, many, much? That is confusing thing. Fine. Let's do that. Yes, everyone. Those exercises which I have given you and the box which we have done in the class, that is your home task. Fine. It should be in your fair notebook. And rule number 1 to 24, they would be submitting your notebooks on Sunday. Don't without listening react, okay? And 25 till last, they would be submitting on next Sunday. Don't react without waiting, please. So, roll number 26 onwards, they will be submitting today. Fine? So, this is thing. Let's continue. Yes, Saturday and Sunday, I've already told you, I'll be collecting the notebooks. That's it. Last important topic is left. Difference. In, write down, difference in meaning. You can give separate heading to this thing. Yes, boys, at last. Yes, wait. Don't close it. Write down a few, little, a little, the little. Clear? You have written this? Now kindly note down. With first, few is used, but itna likh lo, countable nouns. Write down here. I don't want to waste your time. Be quick enough. Countable nouns. A few means some in number. Second pe likho, some in number. The few. Not many, but all of them. Quick beta. Third pe likho. Not many, but all of them. Little. Uncountable nouns. A little. Some in quantity. A little, some in quantity. The little means not much, but all of that. With this, I end this meet.